Just spent 2 hours on the phone dealing with my wireless carrier. Not sure how that's going to affect my mood while watching this. I might root for Order 66. Hello everyone, Jeremy here. Today I'm about to take a look at Obi-Wan Has PTSD by Samurai Sosa. This is by popular demand. I've had so many people come to me and leave comments about how I need to watch this video. Because I guess because I love Obi-Wan so much and I have such a strong reaction to the New Hope Obi-Wan as well as prequel Obi-Wan. Plus also I really, really enjoyed Before the Dark Times, which I just recently did on the channel. If I watch two similar ones in a row, it can affect me. So I really hope it doesn't. Or at least not negatively.
Ben Kenobi? Boy, am I glad to see
you.
Scene
always
makes
me smile.
The Jundland wastes are not to be traveled lightly. Tell me, young Luke, what brings you out this far?
Oh, this little droid.
I've seen this scene so many times.
Master, but I've never seen such devotion in a droid before. He claims to be the property of an Obi-Wan Kenobi. Is he a relative of yours? Do you know who he's talking about?
Obi-Wan Kenobi. Obi-Wan. Now that's a name I've not heard in a long time. A long time.
I think my uncle knows him. He said he was dead.
Oh, he's not dead. Not yet.
Do you know him?
Well, of course I know him. He's me. I haven't gone by the name of Obi-Wan since all before you were born.
Well, then, the droid does belong to you.
I don't seem to remember ever owning a droid. Very interesting. I think we better get indoors.
No, my father didn't fight in the wars. He was a navigator on a spice freighter.
That's what your uncle told you. He didn't hold with your father's ideals, thought he should have stayed here and not gotten involved.
You fought in the Clone Wars?
My eyes are already watering just from that scene.
Yes. I was once a Jedi Knight, the same as your father.
I wish I'd known him.
He was the best star pilot in the galaxy. And a cunning warrior. And he was a good friend. Which reminds me, I have something here for you. Your father wanted you to have this when you were old enough.
What is it?
Father's lightsaber. For over 1,000 generations, the Jedi Knights were the guardians of peace and justice in the Old Republic. Before the Dark Times. Before the Empire.
This is excellent.
How did my father die?
And here comes the lie.
Jedi named Darth Vader, who was a pupil of mine until he turned to evil. Helped the Empire hunt down and destroy the Jedi Knights.
Thank you.
Vader was seduced by the dark side of the Force. Now the Jedi are all but extinct.
Okay, so that was really effective for me. It did remind me a lot of Before the Dark Times, obviously, because it's the same scene and same concept of showing the flashbacks, but it was done very differently, and that's what I really liked. The whole idea that we saw flashes of those moments, where you just hammer home that meaning of what those things are. Best star pilot in the galaxy, the best cunning warrior, a good friend. That good friend, oh good lord. Those wonderful moments where they're just together and being themselves. That it was, what I'm not sure about is the title, the Obi-Wan has PTSD, which quite frankly, going through a war like he did, you probably would, but I don't really feel like that's what was going on there. One of my favorite aspects in that whole video was when we got to see Obi-Wan construct the line, is that, which you can see it in the movie. If just watching A New Hope, you can see it on his face, even though, and I think I've said this before, where, you know, when A New Hope was made, they weren't 100% sure Obi-Wan was lying there, but the way Alec Guinness played it was, he could be lying. Obviously, we now know he was. It just comes off so much better, even with, well, knowing everything we know. And then when you throw in those flashbacks, throw in those scenes that we, oh, man, that scene, just seeing him literally watching Anakin burn. It's like you can see the wheels turning of how did my father die? And you can see the wheels turning. He's flashing back to that moment where he had to, well, at the time, I still believe that he thought he was murdering his best friend, his brother, his son. He's flashing back to that moment and realizing, oh, I'm not going to tell Luke exactly what happened. And it almost makes it as though, not because Luke couldn't handle it, it was almost like Obi-Wan couldn't handle it. Maybe he would have had a plan if he ever met Luke, he couldn't tell him right away, stuff like that. But as it played out, I just kind of had this feeling of Obi-Wan wasn't sure what he wanted to tell Luke. It wasn't so much a certain point of view moment as a, I'm not sure if Obi-Wan was quite ready to face or say out loud what happened. I mean, think about that. He killed his best friend, his son, which I'm sure later he found out, you know, Darth Vader was Anakin. He still had to live with that until he found out. 20 years in the desert's not going to cure all that. Time may heal all wounds, but it leaves scars. And that's something I'm hoping we get to see in the Kenobi series, is maybe see some of those scars, see how all the events of the Clone Wars, of Episode 3, everything that happened, how that affected him while he was on Tatooine. I'm sure he tried to put it behind him, but you would have to carry some of that with you. It would change you fundamentally. For Obi-Wan to go in exile and his sole purpose in life to be watching over Luke from afar, not even being a part of his life, just watching from afar. That would screw with you too. That disconnect, being unable to connect with another human being, especially one that you obviously care for, that's your best friend's son. That's the closest thing you probably have to a grandson, to be honest. How couldn't that hurt you to not be a part of his life? I mean, I know they probably won't go into this. It's Star Wars. They don't go that deep usually into psychology, but it'd be interesting if we even got to see flashes of it, like we saw, like the excellent video we just watched where it showed us the psychology without going into the psychology. You saw the emotion on his face and the reason for that emotion. That's what I love about these videos. They put into context those moments, those small moments, those little looks that people have, those moments of hesitation, those moments of thought. And it just gives it such great context. So anyways, what did you think of this video? Did you enjoy it? I assume you did, because so many of you had suggested it. And I understand why. I completely understand why. It was so good. It's definitely up there for me. But yeah, leave your comments below. And if you have more suggestions, as always, please leave those down there. And if you like this video, please hit like and consider subscribing for more videos like this one. And before I go, as always, Please take care of yourselves, and please take care of each other. Thanks for watching.